This presentation is about the one experience of my team carried out at the University of Valladolid about how to teach the students about computational fluid dynamics. So during the last 10 years we have been preparing workshops and we have found that it's a good methodology for the students to get an insight about the numerical tools and the procedure. So, it's a must-do of teaching computational fluid dynamics to have the practical component. Nowadays, computational fluid dynamics is a very important design tool. And it has been promoted mainly because of the increase of the power of computers. So the main danger, even in the, at the professional use of the of this code is that people tend to use it as a black box. They provide some information and they get results, but the important thing is to get an idea of the weak points, how to improve the models, if the results are suitable or so it's not just to get beautiful pictures. For instance, computational fluid dynamics is known by the acronym CFD, and because the results have so many colors, many people call the CFD the colorful drawings. So on the right side we have the performance of a wind turbine, and on the left side we have a burner. But the idea is it's very easy to get the results, but the important thing is to develop the critical thought about how to improve the models, if the results are realistic, non-realistic, or what is inside of the tool. So it's clear, and it has been stated this idea in many presentations this morning, that when the students have an active role in the learning, they get better insight, they increase the knowledge, and the retention also is higher. So the idea is to get the conclusions just by the practical task the student must do. So focus on our experience. We have been proposing different workshops as a way of learning by doing, and we use classical test cases that can be used on the industrial application or in validation of numerical models, but obviously we scale down to the level of undergraduate students. The idea is, if they are going to do a kind of project, a workshop, the idea is they should do it in less than 20 hours. So obviously we need to simplify the problem and also to provide the idea to make an efficient use of the resources. It's not just to develop a model to run with millions of grid points. The idea is just to do like a game. It's a little play. We are playing to design a kind of system, but with so many simplifications, like the two-dimensional model and with very little grid points, a number of grid points, like 5,000 or something similar. So the motivation is the actual scenario of engineering students. They have good scientific knowledge, but they don't have the perception. They know so many things. And also another problem is that they think they have so much, they know about so many theory, so much theory subject, but they cannot match the theory with the industrial application. Also another point is that they tend to believe that any experimental results or numerical results, they are trustful, they are confident of the results, and the idea is they should be more critical about them. And also sometimes they are a little afraid to make proposals or take creative decisions just to improve the model. So, and we think that with this kind of workshop we can solve this kind of problems. And another thing is that nowadays the information and communication technology makes our work of developing tasks in the virtual campus or very easy, because it's very easy to prepare collaborative or competitive workshops, and also it's very important that there are so many tools to make an objective assessment of the process. The students can work at their own place and in different places. They really appreciate to be able to access to the campus at any time, in any place, and also to be in touch with different agents, learning agents, like student, professor, or something similar, using forums and getting getting the answer to simple questions very quickly. So the idea, what we intend to get with the workshop is, for instance, develop the critical thought of the students about the strong and weak points of each model, and improve the feeling that they can be self-sufficient to improve the models, and also to collaborate with other teams. And also another important thing is that in this kind of workshops they apply concepts of different subjects, so at the end most of the projects are multidisciplinary, and they link theory with application and with other subjects, so they really appreciate this kind of work. And another thing is that we ask them to write a technical report, and so they need to improve the capacity to of synthesis, and also to be able to express correctly with the typical vocabulary of this kind of subject. And the most important, I think I have already talked about this, is the optimization of available resources. So the criteria to select a workshop is that we need very simple geometries, because I told you that we need at least the simplification of 2D models, but with complex flow patterns. We want the students to see, to verify what they learn in theory, like wakes, secondary flows, and so on. Also, we need the problem to be parametric, because we want any group to have the same project, the same level of difficulty, but with different parameters, just to get different flow patterns. And also we need experimental data just to validate. Not to validate, because the model is so simple that the validation can be very poor, but at least to get the certitude of which could be the percentage of accuracy of the model. And also we want that they see this is a kind of industrial application. So we found at the beginning the workshop was just the complete workshop and to produce one report. But we found that the students tend to spend so much time on the first, second task and very little time in the last one. So we have found that splitting the project in some tasks has improved a lot the accomplishment of this kind of project. So the step of a project is the message generation, which is involved with a kind of artistic or creative work, and they have to take their own decision. There are not fixed rules, so they know some tendencies that to improve the model, but they have to develop their own mesh. Also, the algorithm selection is involved with increase the numerical skill of the students. Also, they have to check the performance of different turbulence model and the validation, which is involved with comprehension of the concept, as well as developing the critical thought. And finally, they have to describe the flow pattern, and is more involved with writing technical reports. So here we have a sample of different workshops. For instance, on the left up corner, we have the soil corner, and the parameter we change is different soil numbers just to reproduce different recirculation zones. On the top right corner, we have the aerodynamics of a vehicle, for instance, the Agnes car, and what we change is the inclination of the geometry of the back of the car, so we reproduce different wakes. And also in the left bottom corner, we have the driving cavities. We have fixed walls and a moving wall, which reproduce the kind of flow in lubrication. And also, I have already shown the vertical axis wind turbine, and the parameter we change is the solidity, just to see the way is affecting the incident flow or this kind of things. So the students not only have to produce their project, they have also to review to evaluate the project of another student or another group. So the idea is that sometimes they think that the work was very poor, and when they read another report, they found that there were another point of view, or his work was better than he thought beforehand, or these kind of things. Obviously, the more ponderation is for the score of the professor, is clear. And also, it requires the consistency of decision, ability to synthesize, also the efficient consume of resources, and the appropriate vocabulary, and this kind of things. The survey, at the end of the project, they fill up a survey, and we ask about their perception about the utility of the project, and most of the people agreed that it was very useful to have the hands in this kind of project just to understand the fluid concept. And also they found it would be useful to understand different aspects of other subject, and with reference to their perception about if they could be self-sufficient to use this kind of tools, most of the people thought that they slightly agreed that they could be self-sufficient and they could use this kind of tool in a future. So the conclusion is that there is an evident increase of the success rate in this kind of subject that can be a little complex because it deals with numerical skills and also with fluid dynamics and thermal machines and this kind of subject. And also, obviously, the project must be simplified to a level of the students, because it's the first contact they have with this kind of tool. And with reference to the students, they really appreciate the contacts in the virtual campus and appreciate the collaborative activities, especially because they feel very proud when we pull all the results of different groups in one graph and they see that there are a kind of tendency when they change one parameter of this kind of project. And also, the most important thing is also that they realize that they have more knowledge than what they thought a priori. So, finally, we have the support of educational project from the University of Valladolid in the year 11, 13 and 14. And thank you for everything.